build up to season number 6. With that in mind, let's preview our first team on the show, who just happened to be last year's seller occupiers at the end of the season. Balestier Central Football Club, a team that did pretty well in the first 2 years of the S-League, but dropped in form drastically over the last 3 seasons.
With the young players that we had starting off, they were thrown in on their own without any guidance. So, I mean, hopefully this year the injury toll is going to be a lot less than last year.
The veteran Australian defender will once again don the captain's armband in a season which has a lot of promise for the young and enterprising Tigers side.
I would like to avoid last year's wooden spoon. I think all the players, we were in for a very harrowing time last year, and I think we are a lot wiser after the experience. So that is a spot that we will want to avoid as far as possible. We'll try and do our best. I mean, at the moment, if you ask me, I don't even know the strengths of the other teams. On paper, it looks like SAF and home, maybe Geylang. But really, it's too early to set target at the moment. For me, personally, we are going to look at every match as it comes. But I'm very confident that with a lot of boys that we have had, the team that we have built over the last 3 years, that we'll have a team that is going to fight with the best teams and give them a run for their money.
Sivaji's confidence and belief certainly stems from the average age of the team, which presently is 25. And having concentrated on youth development over the last 3 years, the time could be ripe for a Balestier revival.
I believe that when Sivaji take over for the first year, 98, the squad is quite an experienced squad. So after 99, year 2000, and coming this year, it's all the young player he took in, you see. So he need time to settle down with the young player, and because we don't have much experienced player. So that's caused us this few years we have a problem over there. But in the future, I believe that we can click together and we will go for something else.
Now some of these young guns have been with the club for close to 9 years, and it's surprising that they've not chosen to play elsewhere despite the club's poor showing in recent years.
Since young, when I first step into the field during my 1993 here playing in Toa Payoh, I feel like this field is like my home ground already. Like I don't feel to move to anywhere else. See, like even if the team is not that good, well, I think there's still a chance for them to show in someday. Like we have a good coach like Pian Sivaji. He's a very dedicated coach, and I like his style. He likes to try new youngster, right, for experience exposure. That's what I like about this club.
His commitment to Balestier has also rubbed off on the shoulders of a Brazilian veteran who's playing in his second season at Toa Payoh, making it overall his fifth year in the S-League.
We are professional player football, no? And he is a good club. We have a good coach, good managers. And we can see a lot of youngsters. And the more important thing now we can see for Singapore football is they come up as the youngest, you know. It's good for the team and good for the country, you know. So we can see here a lot of strong guys. We can see a lot of improvement. So what I expect for play for this club, because we feel good to work together with these youngsters, because they want to improve, they want all coming up. So that's why I decided to stay more years in Malaysia.
Now the Tigers have been pretty tight at the back, and this year they've acquired the goalkeeping services of former Marine Castle custodian Hairil Amin.
He's really a very professional coach to me, where the way he approached to players and strategically in the games, he know much more better since he's been taking the Malaysia Cup and our national team. So I guess it's great for me to have a coach like him.
The other foreign signings includes 26-year-old Dorion Krongpol, a striker from Thailand, and a Nigerian midfielder, Okoro Emeka. Now one more star to look out for would be their national midfielder, Ali Imran Lomri, who has had a wonderful stint with the Lions of late.